Hey, what's up, guys? It's Dr. Bion, and welcome back to Mental Health Nation. Now, I want you to do me a favor and remember a time when you had the flu. How were you feeling, especially mentally, like cognitively, thinking-wise? You're probably fatigued. You probably had low energy, maybe mentally stagnated or slow. Basically, slang term for brain fogged, you know, maybe groggy, difficulty focusing, thinking clearly, or even getting up and having the energy to do anything. Now, we've all had the flu, so we've experienced similar things, but what was interesting to me is how these symptoms do a really good job of actually resembling a really common disease or disorder, depression. But it wasn't until I read some research or some literature, which I'll share later in this video, that I actually made this connection, or at least solidified it, you know, in my mind. And it's noteworthy that these symptoms that I just described came after you had actually been inoculated with a virus, okay? So you can actually kind of see what caused it, right? Before and after, what precipitated it. In this case, the influenza virus. And these are, again, symptoms that you didn't have at your baseline. So what changed? In one word, it's inflammation, okay? Inflammation began in both your body and your brain, and of course the brain is just an organ in the body, which is often overlooked, okay? So acute inflammation, or inflammation that happens fast or suddenly, can often be triggered by an infection. Now, what if I told you that chronic inflammatory disorders, you know, longer term inflammatory diseases or processes like heart disease or certain cancers, along with autoimmune disorders, like rheumatoid arthritis or lupus, my goodness, what is this? This can actually help precipitate and be a risk factor for developing depression in people as well. So what I'm trying to get at here is potentially an under-scrutinized link, or an overlooked or maybe not even looked at all link for the most part, between inflammation and depression, okay? So it's important to remember that inflammation is the cornerstone to most diseases. And again, it's often overlooked that the brain is really just another organ in the body. So it's not immune, no pun intended, to, you know, detrimental effects that other parts of the body, you know, can fall victim to. So let's add some proof to the pudding, okay? Number one, an inflammatory cytokine called interferon, which is usually response kind of naturally in the body in response to an infection or a pathogen, can actually be used and is used therapeutically in a clinical setting, you know, given by your physician in patients with hep C or hepatitis C. And what's a common side effect of this inflammatory molecule? It's actually depression. Secondly, depressive episodes have actually been shown to increase the permeability, or the leakage of the brain's blood vessels, you know, into the brain to certain chemicals, with inflammatory cytokines being one. So not only can these molecules help precipitate depression, possibly, but it can also potentially exacerbate an underlying depressive picture as well by allowing more of them to come in and worsen the picture. So how is this all happening on a biochemical level, you know, on a microscopic level? And this is information that wasn't really taught to me anywhere. It's some information that I had to dig up myself. But basically, inflammation in the body or the brain, to simplify it, can inhibit an enzyme, IDO23. And this enzyme usually turns tryptophan in the body to serotonin in the body, okay? So tryptophan is the precursor to serotonin. And serotonin is probably the number one molecule which low levels have been associated, you know, with depression. In fact, most antidepressive drugs work by increasing the access to serotonin in the brain. But when you have inflammation in the body and this enzyme becomes inhibited or less effective, you have less tryptophan into serotonin, and instead you have this tryptophan turning into something called quinolinic acid. And this quinolinic acid is essentially an excitotoxin which activates NMDA glutamate receptors, okay? And glutamate's the number one neurotransmitter in the brain. And really important to note, okay, excess glutamate can also, or may also, inhibit serotonin levels further, okay? So you have a cascade, a trickle-down effect you know, a doubling down of things you don't want in terms of your mood. I'll get into glutamate and other things like that in future videos, but now you know the exact mechanism of action for how inflammation can decrease serotonin and help precipitate or exacerbate depression in essentially anybody. Now, I just don't want to say this information to, you know, make myself look cool or smart, or really not even to give you a bunch of information. What I really want to do is have you use this information practically and really just to help, you know, better your own life or anyone else's life, right now or down the line. You know, if I didn't think these videos could help at least, well, you know, on a very tangible, palpable way, I wouldn't be making these videos. Okay. So I'll give you a few practical tips, okay? And I'm keeping these like super simple. If you haven't noticed, I do that on purpose, right? But tip number one is to eat things and do things that are anti-inflammatory, okay? So instead of promoting inflammation, you promote the inhibition of inflammation, okay? So this would be taking omega-3s, supplements, and taking a diet that's high in antioxidants, okay? So this is mainly vegetables. Of course, fruits can work too. Exercise releases BDNF, and I have the number one BDNF video on YouTube, you know, knock on wood, but check that out as well. And BDNF has been shown to be anti-inflammatory in the brain as well. Other things that I would definitely take a look at are turmeric, which I think has the number one, activates the most anti-cancer genes of any compound in the world, and magnesium, which has a host of beneficial effects that I'll probably cover later. It's one of my personal favorite supplements to take and is also inherently an antioxidant. Number two would be to avoid things that are, yeah, you guessed it, pro-inflammatory, okay? This would be consuming basically a high amount of fats, okay? This is omega-6 fats in particular, but I feel like that confuses people. In general, basically any oil or fat that's not olive oil and coconut oil really has a high chance of being an omega-6 fat. Okay, so this is peanut oil, safflower oil, corn oil, canola oil, etc. Okay, it's essentially in everything. And as you may have seen in my fish oil, you know, supplement video, the average American diet is super high in omega-6s and not enough in omega-3s. And this imbalance of ratios is certainly not helping, you know, the depressive picture of this country. Number three is just taking control of your overall health. As we've described, chronic inflammatory disorders can increase inflammation, which can increase your chances for depression, okay? And stress is actually a pro-oxidant, so avoid that as well. And tip number three is to avoid MSG, okay, monosodium glutamate. And the problem with this is it comes in many different names and forms, so it hides on labels really well. I'll make a video on that again. And as a bonus, from a clinician standpoint, down the line, I believe we could potentially see an increasing ordering of lab markers for depression for inflammation, okay? So this would include, you know, all kinds of things, CRP, tumor necrosis alpha, interleukin-1 beta, interleukin-6, etc. So keep in mind, there's all kinds of nuances that I can't include in a 5-minute YouTube video, but if you resonate with my ideas, my vision, or my message, you, the person watching this video, can subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's free for more life-changing information in the future, okay? So I'm Dr. Bion, and welcome to Mental Health Nation. Till next time. Way too nice, can't fill our shoes. Yeah, we gon' win, they gon' lose. Oh, so hot, but stay so cool. New life, we gon' win, they gon' lose. The violence crazy, the words are true. We gon' win, they gon' lose. Work too hard, paid our dues. We gon' win, they gon' lose. Way too nice, can't fill our shoes. We gon' win, they gon' lose. Oh, so hot, but stay so cool. They gon' lose. We gon'